In our previous video, we showed you how to make a combat-ready lightsaber from scratch. But a lot of you have been asking, can we take a toy lightsaber and turn it into a combat-ready lightsaber? And yes, we can. We already covered how to make the lightsaber from scratch. I don't really want to do that again. So what I want to do is take all the guts out of my combat-ready lightsaber, and I'm going to replace them with the guts from the toy lightsaber. Now, this is a Bladebuilders lightsaber I picked up marked down for $10 at Walmart, but it still has motion sensor, clash, and hum sound. And the ends are just glued on. In order to take the body apart, I have to take a little end ring off because this is one piece. I'm gonna go ahead and cut the end off this one because it was glued on really well. I've had ones where I can just twist them off. There it goes. So inside we have the LED. This is what's supposed to illuminate the blade. It is connected to the circuit board. This is what the entire brains are. This has your clash sensor, and on the underside it has the motion sensor so it knows when you're swinging it around. And everything's attached to it. The two yellow wires come off to the on-off switch. It's just a momentary switch. The two green wires come down to the speaker. And the whole thing is mounted to the molded-in battery compartment. So in order to remove the circuit board, I'm gonna have to cut the positive and negative lead from the battery compartment. I'm removing the remainder of the positive lead. I don't need that. And then here's the tail from the negative lead. So let me put this into the clamp because there's something I really want to show you here. Something I like is they labeled everything on the circuit board. Down here you have the V plus. The V plus is actually the positive lead in from the battery pack. The V minus is where the negative lead in goes from the battery pack. Down here you have an SP plus and an SP minus. Those are the leads to the speaker. And on this side, you have the LED plus and minus. Now that's actually important. If you don't hook the LED up correctly, it won't light up. But if it is incorrect, it's not gonna hurt the LED. Just take it off, flip it around, and it'll come back on. So I've got the batteries jumped back to the board so it'll turn on, just so I could show that while this LED looks bright, it really isn't gonna be bright enough for our blade. What I'm gonna do is take it off and replace it with a high intensity LED that I bought from LED Supply. Disassembling a board is easy. All you have to do is heat up the existing solder and pull the wires right out. Last time, I attached everything hardwired to the circuit board, which made it a little tricky to get into the housing that it made. So this time, I'm gonna make everything modular using JST connectors. Now you can order these as single pairs that attach together, or you can order a jumper and just cut them in half. Either way, they're really cheap. So I'm gonna make it modular, which will make it much easier to put into my housing, as well as in the future, I can swap out my blue LED for a red LED when I decide to go Sith. Now the circuit board limits the amount of voltage going to the LED so it doesn't blow out the LED that it's made for. It's not enough power to power the high powered LED. In order to provide more power, I need to hook up a PNP type power transistor. What this does is it kind of acts like a relay. When the board triggers it, it will reroute the proper voltage to the high power LED. This particular one is an NTE378. This is what I'm going to use for the power. I pre-tinned the braided wire to help make this easier. Since I'm repurposing existing electronics, I can actually reuse a lot of the solder that's already on the board. Sometimes I have to add a little, but for the most part, I can just melt what's there and attach my new wires. What I'm trying to do is add the first leg that goes to the transistor. So what this is I'm actually going to be jumping the power from the battery pack to the transistor. And then the black wire, I'm actually going to use the negative from the LED. I'm only going to use the negative LED lead off the circuit board. All the positive power is coming from the transformer. I don't need to hook anything up to the positive LED lead. I'm adding heat shrink tubing, so once all this is inside of the saber, the wires won't short each other out. The PNP type power transistor actually has an orientation. We need to make sure we hook up the right wires to the right leg. Now with the three legs, I need to take the negative from the LED lead off the circuit board and attach it to this outside leg. And this other outside leg is where I'm gonna be hooking up the positive lead directly from the power pack. And when it switches, it'll be sending that out the middle leg to my new high power LED. In order to properly hook up my high power LED, I'm gonna be using an LED driver. This is a 1425 MicroPuck driver. I also got this from LED Supply. I'm gonna take the red positive power wire and hook it up to the middle leg here of the transformer. Now, you don't have to use the MicroPuck. You could hook up just a resistor, but the MicroPuck will maintain the brightness of the LED until the batteries are dead. I'm gonna go ahead and put a piece of shrink tube over the end of the PNP power type transistor. I don't know if it's gonna short out inside the saber hilt or not. I don't wanna take that chance. And I'll use the black negative lead directly to the negative on the battery. And then I have an orange positive and green negative to hook up to the LED. At this point, I want to attach JST connectors to the wires so I can disconnect the LED if I so choose. LED. So this is the high power LED that I purchased. What's nice is on the board again, you have these inputs of the negative and the positive for the power. It gives you two sets. It doesn't matter which one you hook up as long as you put positive to positive and negative to negative. So my LED hooked up. I'll just plug in the battery. I have my high powered LED hooked up. Now I'm still using the stock speaker that was part of the toy, which of course works and it'll sound fine. From my old build, I have a battery speaker combo that I bought. Now this has a much deeper and richer sound and I actually want to use that instead, but you don't have to do that. If you like, you can save yourself about 16 bucks and just get a cheap battery holder and hook that up and keep the speaker that came with the toy. So what I want to do now is disconnect the stock speaker and hook up my speaker. And that's my speaker. I think it's worth it. The LED actually needs a heatsink. This thing generates a lot of heat when it's running. Now you can buy a specialized heatsink, but in order to easily fit inside the saber, I'm just gonna attach a bolt to the back of it. This will suck enough heat away from the LED, it's not gonna be a big deal. Now I did go ahead and pick up some heatsink transfer stickers from LED Supply, because these were really cheap. And it affixes just like a sticker on the back. Now this is a focusing lens. This is a narrow beam spot. Again, LED Supply sells this, and they are cheap. This entire assembly was less than a dollar. It just fits directly on top of the LED. And then I'm gonna put shrink tubing over all of this to hold it all together. So this is just a piece of 1¼-inch shrink tubing. Make sure the lens doesn't fall off. Not that I need to, but I want to trim the excess off. Now I did this differently than I had in the previous video, but I think this way is simpler and easier for me. Now the last thing I want to change, the switch. I've been keeping the stock switch because it's easy for testing. You can just turn it on and turn it off. But I have a built-in switch in my hilt that I'd rather use. So I'm going to disconnect this, attach one last JST connector, and then I'm good to reassemble my saber. That's all the electronics. It works. One last precaution, I want to take another piece of clear shrink tube and put it over the circuit board so nothing shorts out inside the saber. using AAA batteries is very easy, but we found a problem while shooting the episode for Beyond Geek. During combat, they'll actually pop out of the holder. So we did two things to correct that. First, I cut little tiny bits of EVA foam from a garage mat and put it where the springs are. That gave it a lot more tension. And then we took electrical tape and wrapped it around the top and bottom to really hold them in place. These are just a couple of small set screws, and I'm using them to hold the battery compartment in place. Now the LED easily fits, but I think I'd like to take a small piece of pipe and cut it so that it actually fits snugly. So what I have here is it's just a piece of 1-inch diameter, schedule 80, or thin-walled PVC pipe. Now it's set to where these set screws push against the PVC pipe. May not be quite as responsive as the more expensive board, but come on, I've got a combat-ready lightsaber made with a $10 toy for the soundboard. This whole build is $65, $80, depending on if you want to just use the stock speaker or not. Wish I had this when I was a kid. Hey, thanks for watching Beyond Geek DIY Builds. If you want to see full episodes of Beyond Geek, you can catch that on Amazon for free. Make sure you subscribe because we'll be bringing you more exciting content.